church hasn't heard this many voices in a long time. A community here to celebrate its 70th anniversary. Established back in 1947, it was more than just a church for Pacific people. It allowed early migrants to settle, to form new communities and raise their children.
For us, it's really our foundation where our parents brought us here just to go to Sunday school. And really that was the beginning of us learning how to sing.
I felt quite emotional, really. We were very, very young when we started, but Mum and Dad brought us here like 6 days a week.
My parents came in the early 50s, and so for them and for my children, it's really important that they know that there is a history.
Through here, we grew up with a certain group of people that we were really comfortable with, so Pacific Islanders. We also understood who we were as people, and this is the foundation of where that all is.
Nestled on Edinburgh Street off Auckland's historic K Road, the church resembled a village, a slice of the Pacific way of life. Yvonne first stepped through these doors when she was 9 years old, not knowing a word of English. She has been coming to this church every Sunday for over 60 years.
I came here in 1953, and my mum, the late Christina Purcell, she was already a member here with the Yandle family. Bonson Bay was heavily populated by the islanders. That's where all our family lived, and Graylin. And you know, one of the most fondest memory after church is people walking. So you had all these people walking along K Road, Bonson Bay Road, Great North Road. And that's what you don't see them now anymore, right? It was beautiful, especially the first end of the month. Everybody was in white.
The church was founded by Reverend Robert Challis, who retired from missionary work in the Cook Islands to serve Cook Islanders and Niueans here in New Zealand. He was assisted by the Rev Dario Te Aia from the Cook Islands, and later Rev Leawatia Seo from Samoa, who was ordained in 1951. Roz Tuitama has been a part of the team who have set up a museum across the road from the church in the Māori Hall.
We use the term Pacific Island to group us as one group, but this church is actually a body of people. Cook Island, Niuean, Samoan and English speaking. There is no museum in New Zealand that actually tells the story of our people that have come and settled in here about 70 years ago or so. So the reason why this is here is to tell their story their way.
Many acknowledge their past leaders.
We start off with Reverend Challis, and then we move to Reverend Leawatia Seo. He begins to work with Reverend Challis, not in just the faith focus, but almost like social workers, meeting people at the boat, the wharf, meeting people at the airport, filling out forms.
Whenever we're in the office on a Wednesday afternoon, we had people coming in for Reverend Challis, Reverend Seo, Reverend Elise, the Niueans, to say, look, we want an interview, we're going for an interview, what do you say? And hopefully what they were taught here was what they said.
The church was active with sports teams and choirs, and in the 1960s and 70s, there saw a boom in New Zealand-born Pacific Islanders. Many young attended Sunday school and Bible class, not only to practice their faith, but to speak English. Members of that Bible class celebrated their own reunion in November.
We felt that we were overlooked by our parents in the different languages, and we're caught between being a New Zealander, Pacific Islander, and you know, our parents were migrants, and they spoke in their language, and we were only familiar in English, because they didn't want us to learn the Pacific Island languages, because they wanted us to grow up in the society, perfecting our English so we could get good jobs and to succeed.
We're that first generation that experienced New Zealand, the education system, the opportunities.
Today's been quite a good experience for me, just to see like the history of my church.
I think for me it's such a blessing to be here. My grandparents immigrated when they immigrated to Auckland. Newton was the first home for them, and ever since we've been there.
It's pretty cool, eh? Because like, just the church is just so historical itself, especially for like central Auckland and just Auckland in general.
I always looked at my past, and I hope we are doing a good job.
Amen.